Moreno, this is Ben, and we're going to be going over basic safety tips for the belt sander so you can keep all your fingers and toes. Falling
up to the beat. The trigger can be locked on. If you were to plug it in right now, it will just take off on you. So make sure your trigger lock is not engaged by squeezing the trigger a few times before you plug it in. You have to be very careful to not get any loose clothing, such as your sleeves, shirt tail, or pants, caught in the action of the sander belt. Start by removing anything baggy, or consider wearing a shop apron that will keep everything tucked in around your waist.
I wear a tool belt that keeps shirt tails, things like that, secured, tucking in your shirt. There's so many different options. Again, it comes down to being safe, but what works best and allows you to remain comfortable.
Make sure you're keeping your hands above and away from the open, exposed side of the belt.
Simply put, if it's moving, keep your hands away from it.
With the cord, since we're going to be covering a lot of ground, you want to make sure it's set somewhere where you won't be tripping on it and it won't be snagging on anything. You'll also want to hold the cord away from the intake of the belt.
I like to have both hands on the sander, but I make sure I've got the cord over my hand so that it has to go past my hand in order for it to get caught in. But everybody's different. You do what feels comfortable. The last thing you want to do is use a tool and feel awkward with it. Again, that's where mistakes are made. You need to make sure you got the proper safety gear. Glasses, ear protection, especially while sanding, some type of a mask, cover your face.
So if you're sanding something large like this, it's not gonna move at all. But sanding anything smaller, the action of the belt is enough to send that piece of wood flying. And you're gonna wanna make sure to immobilize it somehow.
You can do that with either using clamps, stop blocks, or even grip tape, something that gives resistance to the motion of the sander so you're not sending pieces across and hitting the guy on the other side of the room.
Make sure the trigger is not locked before you plug it in. Make sure you're keeping everything out of the action of the sander.
You need to make sure you got the proper safety gear. And if it is any type of a smaller piece that has a remote possibility of moving while sanding it, make sure it's properly secured in one of the ways we mentioned before.